Thank you. warn about them being so merciful and kind. Chant the names of boys to protect the child from harm.
But I think that you are not prepared for this. No? Why? It was very auspicious day to play that song. Can you play tomorrow? Anyhow, some will be Hiranyakashipu, some will be Prahlad, some will be Mahavishnu. Anyhow, I want that day. Tomorrow in the evening, we have a very good drama and yes, make arrangement for that. And then, in a study also, you should sing Hare Krishna. You should read. Then that, you should off, you should read. Second part.
Krishna, Krishna.
Hare Krishna. And he will take your all problems. Like he took all the problems and set Prahlad Maharaj and quickly destroyed. Hiranyakashipu, a person who was like never to be died. So strong like iron, not to be dead in scoil or here, there, not by beaten, not by them, not by human, not by any animals. Not in fire, not in by poison, anything, but quickly, in a moment, and he was dead. So, missing him is here and there, everywhere. So, I am taking the shelter of Prapadde Aham. Aham means myself. Prapadde means I am taking shelter of missing. So, you should, any difficulty, anywhere, any problem, so much danger of life or anything, you can chant this mantra and surely he will save you and you can taste it. But you should be very thankful to him. Otherwise not. You should be like Prahlad Maharaj. And he will take out all the difficulties, problems in chanting, remembering and being a devotee. He has come like a mercy, abodement of mercy of Krishna. So he has come only to save us. So you should pray this mantra today and he will save you.
Ito nishinga parto nishinga.
Ito nishinga.
Jato jami tato nisinga. पैशन करे
Very good class. Are you all satisfied?
Yes.
You all? We should try to become and follow Prahlad Maharaj. Then Nishing will also always he will have. He must help. He is always greedy to help us. He wants, but we don't want. Where you have given your this throat? You have sold anywhere?
No.
Somewhere?
Cold.
Not sold, but cold and fasting.
Then there. Heard from Prahlad Maharaj, and especially this, that Nishkinchanana Mahiyasan Padra Yogi Sekam Nishkinchanana Dabhya. Anyone cannot have these kinds of faith and affection to Krishna, love and affection to Krishna, like Prahlad Maharaj. And he heard, and all are blind, and they are like dogs. Punas punas charvitana, like dogs. Dogs think themselves to be intelligent, very intelligent. There were once some dogs were there, and they found a very dry bone, something dry, chamada. The skin was also there, but it is dry. There was no rush. No rush, please?
No.
Juice at all. Particularly, one dog came and took it. And he ran very fast. And he was looking towards all other dogs. And they were all began to
chase.
And to take that thing. Even there was no juice, nothing but dry, only bone. But all their wantings, pursuing him to take. And at last, they catch hold of that dog who had in his mouth that dry bone and began to cut here and there. And that dog became full of injuries and blood began come here and there. And he was now so much taken away. And he he was bound to give up. And he gave up, throw out his that bone, and quickly taking his tail inside his behind her leg, his leg.
Inside his hind leg.
And he became a one-sided. And watching that, looking that what is going on. And those one dog at once took that bone and wanted to take some juice from there. But all dogs, about 13, 14, 15, 20 dogs attacked on to take. So we are like that. Our fathers have taken juice, nothing in this world, like bone and that dry. Where? In all worldly happinesses. Like same. If you ask your forefather who has become 84 or 90 or 100, are you happy? What you have done in your whole life? No, I am not. Why? Oh, I have now become old. I cannot taste so many things. If I take anything, I cannot digest. I am now going to die. I am not. But his descendant, his sons and children think that, oh, taking from our fathers and forefathers, now we will be very happy. But saying, nothing. If a man thinks that I will take so much wine, and he is taking so much wine, then what will be? What? He will like that. He will fail in a brain. Then bad brain. And he will think that I am sitting in the throne, very golden. I am monarch of all. But dog will smell that, oh, some good smell is coming. And they will come and they test by their tongue and they will wash his paws. So this. So there is nothing in all this. No taste, no juice, nothing in worldly things. So Prahlad Maharaj is taken. And Reinhard Hrenekalya became very furious. He wanted to kill him. But he could not. He was now thinking, what should I do? I think that a death can come from this war. I could not kill him. So I am fearing that something can come from him and I will die. But in the meantime, his very dear sister named Holika came. And he told, my brother, dear brother, why you have so much anxious and worry? Can I help you? No, in this world, anyone cannot help you. Oh, I can help you. What do you want? I want that my son should be killed. Oh, you are? Oh, very happy. Very easily I will do. How? I have some benediction. I have done very hard stories. And benediction came to me that you will not die, you will not burn in fire. So I know this vidya,
knowledge.
I will take that ball in fire and it will be. But that is, then he began to laugh. Oh, my sister, save me. Oh, yes, tomorrow you should arrange very heap of dry roots. And then I will take that boy in my lap and I will sit in the heap of that wood and some ghee and some burning all should be given on the oats and some fire should be given. At once it will go, so high flame, and in a minute he will be right. And I will come out of fire, all there, done. And in the morning, a very big heap of dry wood was given, and so much ghee, so much of all things were given. And she took Prahlad, all my dear nephew, you should come in my yard. I will give you so much milk and everything. And taking, and she sat on the in the midst of that dry goods. And when she sat easily, taking Prahlad Maharaj in her lap, at once fire was given in all way, all round. And very quickly, the fans began to go to touch his coin. And great big sound was there. Then, all that thing that, oh, they are covered by fire. They must be burnt. Hiranyakashipu was satisfied that his sister will come laughing to me and tell that all, oh, everything has been finished. But quickly they saw Prahlad Maharaj coming from the fire, and his sister was never returned. She was burned into ashes at once. Hiranyakashipu told that, why, how you say? Oh, when I was sitting there, I saw that my mother, auntie, has been burned, and anyone came to me and he covered me with me like a coke, what is it?
Like ice.
Like ice. And I was easily saved. But I'm so worried for my auntie. She was also saved. Then became so fearful. What to do and why? Then the two gurus told, why you are so much worried? You have conquered whole world. You have conquered air, fire, all five elements even. You can fly in the air easily. You can take the thunderbolt also. You can defeat Brahma. You can defeat Indra. Everyone. Why you are? Oh, wait a little, or father will come and he will easily solve this problem. And then Prahlad was again sent to his school. There one day, that though teachers were engaged anyhow in household works, jobs, and they told that, Prahlad, you should work like monitor. In this country's monitor, you should. And see that they should not do anything wrong, because the boys are naughty. So you should control them. I'm just returning and telling you that. Then what became? You should hear very patiently and to follow.
Om Gyanam Simaram Dasya Gyanam Gyanam Salam Chakshurum Nitham Gyanam Tasmai Sri Gurudev Namah. Vancha kalpataru pyaksha kripa sindhu veva cha patitanam pavanecha upaishra vecha mordhava. I offer my own obeisances unto my beloved Gurudev Om Vishnu Pada Paramahamsa Parivetya Hanya Srisila Bhaktivedanta Narayana Maharaj, of the all our gurus in the Guru Parampara coming from Ashtanga the Guru Swami, of all the Vaishnavas present and all the guests I have joined this place. So Samdana Markade told Hiranyakashipu, don't worry, we will take care of this boy, as they had already promised before a few times. They said, this boy is quite young, and when they are young, they are very easily to be influenced. He will give himself with association.
Where is Tungi Jaliti? Where?
Tungi.
Where is he?
He's there.
Stand up. I don't want to. Why not here? You should be ready to tell something.
So, Samdana Maharaja said, we will bring our father Sukracharya and he will influence. By his association, this boy will change very quickly and learn all these good things about materialistic life, dharma, artha, kama, and moksha like that. So, Prahlad Maharaj, when Samdana Maharaja left, and there was, as Sri Gurudev said, some monitoring to be done by him, the children, his classmates, they wanted to play and in this way enjoy their time. Prahlad Maharaj said, however, that listen to me, I want to tell you something. And in this way Prahlad Maharaj started his teachings to the boys. And the boys, who had so much respect and affection for Prahlad, they sat down with this mood. They were ready to hear. So this is very helpful. If we want to learn anything, we should be very faithful, respectful, and with affection hear from the lotus mouth of Śrīla Gurudev. So Śrī Prahlāda Maharaj, who is one of our Mahajans, he is not an ordinary devotee. He is to be followed, his activities are to be followed. And one thing which is very special in Prahlad Maharaj, as we heard this morning, he did not receive diksha in the ordinary way. He received diksha or initiation in the womb of his mother from Narada Muni. So we should be very sure that this is the right process to hear from the proper source and to realize it within our hearts. So Prahlad Maharaj started to instruct his classmates. The first thing he said is Kaumara Achyala Pratyo Bhagavat Dharmam Bhagavatam Iha Dullabam Manusam Janma Tatati Adul Adrubam Arthada. So Prabhupada said, when we are very young, Kaumara means young age, about 5 years, we should decide what is right and what is wrong in life. We have received some very good intelligence in this human form of life, which is very rare. It is adrupam, temporary. It is adulabam, very rare. But even though it is temporary, it is so valuable. Artada, so valuable that in this life we can perform devotional service, devotional activities, by which we can free ourselves from this bondage of materialistic existence. So Prahlad advised his school friends, in this life, human life, we should try to perform devotional activities, devotional services. And this, from boyhood, yeah, from early age, we may think, oh, I will do it later on. This is our mood. When we are young, we want to play. And we think anything which is so important, we will do when we grow older. At best is, we will do it when we are quite old. Yeah? After enjoying ourselves in this life, we will perform some devotional activities when we are quite old. Yeah? In general, the human body exists for about 100 years. 100 years is actually very rare in this age of Kali. But the description...
They asked him, Prahlad, like a question, why we should do from beginning of life, being an infant boy of 4 or 5 years? We will do it after 80 years when we will enjoy everything. We will be expert and thus in the last 8 or 4 days, we will give all these things. We will remember Krishna. Then what he replied?
Prahlad Maharaj said that when we are young, our...
Not young.
Yes. When we are just very young, 5 years old, there is nothing. Our hearts are very soft and pliable. There is no strong impressions yet there from this outside world. So when we, at that time, decide what is right and what is wrong, then we can choose the right activities in this life.
Also, there is no guarantee that we will be young. From early age, we can die in the age of 7, 8, 9, 10, and we cannot be young. And if you are dying, then you will not be old. So older is age is never to come for them. So do eat it more. Then go on.
So right now, when we are very young, we should decide what is the right path to follow. Prahlad Maharaj explained that
Natta Kartavyo Jat Ayu Vayah Param. What is the meaning?
Prahlad Maharaj is explaining, telling his demonic friend, tat prayaso na kartavya, don't do so much effort by which you can lose your age. But if you engage this energy for Krishna, for Hari, then your life will be successful and you can gain more.
Na tat prayaso kartavya jat ayu vyah param. You should not be worried for your maintaining life. To be happy. To be with family. To marriage. And to support children and nourish. And then I will build so much high class of any house. Then I will make a very beautiful garden. Then very beautiful dogs, strong dogs will be there. And I will talk taste everything there. I know that this is to waste time. If sufferings we don't want, but even then it comes, suffering. We want to be old, but oldness will come. We want never sufferings, but sufferings is bound to come by past birth impressions. So if you have done any job or anything for happiness, it will all come automatically. Everything, your managing of maintaining life, good wife, good children, happiness, everything will come automatically. Why you are doing so all this? If automatically sukh will come, like dukh, like misery, everything will come. So why you are not from the beginning chanting, here is happiness, not wrong.
The demonic friend is telling, oh Prahlad, we shall alive for a long time. No need to start from boyhood. And Prahlad Maharaj is giving a sketch of our lifetime. That we are about our age about 100 years.
Suppose
we are
everyone cannot live 100 years. But suppose
we live in this world about 100 years. Among these 100 years, we work in daytime and sleep at night. So half age we spend on sleeping only. So So from 100 years, if we cut to half percent, 50% that for sleeping, then only 50 years is still there. So from 80 to 100, it is too old. You can't be straight also. You can't digest anything. So many diseases. If you want to put your step here, it will go there. And